you.
And with your spirit.
I am Father Quang Đức Tinh, Provincial of the Chicago Province. I want to welcome you all to today's special celebration, profession of perpetual vows of our two brothers, Carol Gales and Derek Nguyễn. This is the day of joy and gratitude. Joy because we are about to receive two full members into the society of the divine word. Gratitude, we give thanks to God for these two vocations. These two brothers decided to dedicate their whole lives for the kingdom of God. As we just sing, let us build the house of love. They want to go out to build a house of love for the people, for the kingdom of God. Let us be grateful to God and to all of us who have been supporting these two men in their vocation journey. Let us now take a moment to ask the Lord for forgiveness for the sins we have committed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that the grace of baptism should flourish in these your servants, so that they might strive to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son, grant, we pray, that constantly seeking evangelical perfection, they may add to the holiness of your church and increase her apostolic zeal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Bài trích sách tiên tri Isaiah: đến cạn đi, hỡi những người đang khát, nước đã sẵn đây, dầu không có tiền bạc, cứ đến mua mà dùng, đến mua rượu, mua sữa, không phải trả đồng nào. Sao lại phí tiền bạc vào của không nuôi sống, tốn công lao vất vả vào thứ chẳng làm cho chắc dạ no lòng. Hãy chăm chú nghe ta, thì các ngươi sẽ được ăn ngon, được thưởng thức cao lương mỹ vị. Hãy lắng tai và đến với ta, hãy nghe thì các ngươi sẽ được sống. Ta sẽ lập với các ngươi một giao ước vĩnh cửu, để trọn lề nhân nghĩa với David. Này, ta đã đặt David làm minh chứng cho các ngươi, làm thủ lãnh chỉ huy các nước. Này, ngươi sẽ chiêu tập một dân tộc ngươi không quen biết, một dân tộc không quen biết ngươi sẽ chạy đến với ngươi, vì Đức Chúa, Thiên Chúa của ngươi, vì Đức Thánh của Israel đã làm cho ngươi được vinh hiển. Hãy tìm Đức Chúa khi người còn cho gặp, kêu cầu người lúc người ở kề bên. Kẻ gian ác, hãy bỏ đường lối mình đang theo. Người bất lương, hãy bỏ tư tưởng mình đang có mà trở về với Đức Chúa, và người sẽ xót thương. Về với Thiên Chúa chúng ta, vì người sẽ rộng lòng tha thứ. Thật vậy, tư tưởng của ta không phải là tư tưởng của các ngươi, và đường lối các ngươi không phải là đường lối của ta, sấm ngôn của Đức Chúa. Trời cao hơn đất chừng nào, thì đường lối của ta cũng cao hơn đường lối các ngươi, và tư tưởng của ta cũng cao hơn tư tưởng các ngươi chừng ấy. Cũng như mưa với tuyết xa xuống từ trời, không trở về trời nếu chưa thấm xuống đất, chưa làm cho đất phình nhiêu và đâm chồi nảy nọc, cho kẻ gieo có hạt giống, cho người đói có bánh ăn, thì lời ta cũng vậy. Một khi xuất phát từ miệng ta, sẽ không trở về với ta nếu chưa đạt kết quả, chưa thực hiện ý muốn của ta, chưa chứng toàn sứ mạng ta giao phó. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. trust we shall not fear, for the Lord is our strength, the Lord is our song. He became our Savior. We shall shout aloud joyfully,
singing joyfully, singing joyfully.
We shall draw water joyfully from the wellsprings of salvation. Give thanks, oh, give thanks to the Lord. Give praise to His holy name. Make His mighty deeds known to all of the nation. Proclaim His greatness.
Thank you. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus saw at the water's edge two boats left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. When Jesus had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we've worked hard all night and haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets began to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so full that the boats began to sink. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord, I am a sinful man." For he and all his companions were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken. And so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, Simon's partners. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will fish for people." So they pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
So, the following members have requested to take perpetual vows in the Society of the Divine Word: Carl Edward Gales, Derek Joseph Nguyễn,
dear brothers, what do you ask of God and of the church?
We ask to commit ourselves to Christ and to his church by pronouncing perpetual vows in the Society of the Divine Word.
May the Lord grant you his help. May the Divine Word be your guide. May the Spirit be your light.
Bring to my mind is a word that is actually not in the readings at all. The word is abundance. All who are thirsty, come to the waters. No doubt, gushing abundantly from what the psalm says are the wellsprings of salvation. Buy wine and milk without money or cost. Abundant generosity. Eat the richest fare, heaps and heaps of good food. Not just from McDonald's, Terry, but more like the amazing food that Carl, you love to watch being prepared on the Food Channel. The readings go on. God endows Israel with splendor. Israel is said to all the nations, and all nations will run to Israel. Millions and millions of people from all sorts of cultures and exotic places. Abundance. God will freely pardon. Abundant mercy. And the word of God goes out and will not return empty. Abundant return. In the second reading, we hear about the abundant love of Christ in the Spirit, the water, and the blood pouring forth abundantly. Of course, in the Gospel, we hear the story of a huge, abundant catch of fish. The disciples go out into deep water. The catch is so big, so abundant, that the nets begin to break. And then they call over their companions, and they put the fish in another boat, and the boats begin to sink. And then the story of the disciples' abundant response. They leave everything and follow Jesus. What you are doing today, Carl and Derek, is also about abundance. You've experienced the abundance of the water of the Spirit, the nourishment of God. The call to go out to the ends of the earth, the richness and fertility of God's Word. You've been caught up in that great net of God's mercy and love. You, like the disciples, are giving an abundant, over-the-top response today. You're leaving your family. You're leaving the security of your cultures, where you feel comfortable. And you're going to places and peoples that you do not yet know. You're leaving everything to follow Jesus of Nazareth, the Christ, to be in a special, abundant way, missionary disciples in the society of the divine word. This is the meaning of the perpetual lifetime vows that you profess today. As I have said so often, these are in no way final vows. We throw that off. Well, today is final vow weekend. No, no. These are not final vows. They're rather the beginning of a lifetime of growth. As a musician, Carl, you know that you never reach a final stage of being a musician, of practicing your art. You continue to practice and practice and practice, and you never quite get it right, do you? And it's like your efforts to learn Spanish here. You have to practice and learn and practice and learn and make mistakes and learn every day, perpetually. And as you continue to practice the vows that you'll profess today, you will grow into the image that Jesus gives the disciples in the gospel today. What they leave everything for. And that is to become fishers of people. Fishers of women and men. Now, I want you to imagine the abundance of this image. It could seem to be a very tame one. I know Derek, you love fish, you know, and it's fun. You know, it's very relaxing. You sit there with your pole in the water and catch something, maybe something good to eat. Wonderful. Waiting for the fish to bite. But this is not the image of being a fisher of people. This would be an image of someone who just sits in the rectory and has his pole in the water waiting for the fish to come to you. That is not what Jesus has in mind. The image that Jesus uses in the gospel is to put down your nets. If you've ever seen fishermen, fisher people on a boat, you know that's a lot of work. That's a lot of work. The nets are heavy, and it's tiring, and it's often unsuccessful. But a good fisherman keeps on going. When I hear this image also, I think of the image of the fishermen that I saw day after day when I would come to the beach when I worked in the Philippines years ago. You know, they had these nets that they would cast out like that. These huge nets. And they would throw their whole body into this. And then they pull this net up. And then they have to sort out the fish. And they have to throw some away. It's not easy. My friend Clement Sedmak has written that Jesus does not call us to a comfortable life. Jesus calls us to a deep life. Clement says, you know, that Peter probably would have an easier life as a fisherman, to stay by the shores of the Sea of Galilee, as hard as it is. You might have an easier life too, Derek, to just be a fisherman. Enjoy life. And you might have an easier life, Carl, if you just pursued your career as a musician. But religious life and ministry in the church calls you to deep life. You have to use abundant energy, day after day, perpetually. Day after day, you have to put out into the deep waters and to find as ministers, as fishers of people, of women and men. Because of God's call, you want to do this. God has called you. You're responding. And this is what we celebrate today. Not the end, but the beginning. And of course, you can't do it alone. You need the abundant help of the people among whom you minister and serve and are called to inspire. You need the abundant support of your SVD confreres and SSBS sisters. You need the abundant love and support of your friends and families. Of course, you may also fail abundantly. But your vows mean that you keep going. Ultimately, I think we know in faith, we believe in faith, that your abundant effort, day after day, putting out into deep water, casting your nets, this effort will be rewarded. Maybe not in ways you know. Maybe in ways you don't expect, or perhaps then never know. But there will be a large catch of fish, because like God's word, the net never comes back empty. Sisters and brothers, today, all of us, are invited by Derek's and Carl's abundance to join them in spirit as they profess their perpetual vows and in a very rich and deep way renew their baptismal vows. So all of us here, without exception, are invited to renew our baptismal vows together with Carl and Gary. All of us who are religious are invited to renew our own vows. And all of us who are SVDs and SSPS sisters are called to renew our own missionary discipleship in the Arnoldus family. So, Derek and Carl, come to the water. Embrace every culture and nation that Christ loves so passionately and so abundantly. Do the hard work of letting down your nets and pulling them up again. Do it for life, perpetually. Do it with abandon, and do it with abundance. Amen.
dear brothers. Through baptism, you are already dead to sin and consecrated to the Lord. Are you prepared to unite yourselves more closely to Him by the bond of perpetual profession into society of the divine word?
I am so resolved.
Are you resolved with the help of God's grace to bind yourselves forever to poverty, chastity, and obedience in imitation of Christ, the incarnate word?
I am so resolved.
Are you resolved to place yourselves under the guidance of the Holy Spirit at the service of the gospel and the church to preach the good news of salvation as divine word missionaries?
I am so resolved.
May the one who began this work in you bring it to fruitful completion. May the divine word walk with you and grant you confidence, strength, and comfort. May the Spirit of Holiness grant you the gifts of perseverance. Please stand. My dear friends, let us pray to the triune God who has called these servants to follow Christ with complete dedication. May God bless them with His grace and strengthen them in their resolve, following the example of the holy men and women who have gone before us.
Thank you.
Loving God, hear the prayers of your people. By your grace, prepare the hearts of your servants for their religious profession. May the fire of the Holy Spirit purify them from all sin, and make them burn with your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Protect and guide these servants of yours.
Give them the joy of vows fulfilled. Made whole in your love. May they enjoy the communion of the saints and with them praise you forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, Carl and Derek, we welcome you forever as our brothers in society of the divine. Please stand to offer our prayers to the Lord.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that he may guide the Church with love. We also pray for all government leaders and civil authorities, that they may follow the humble example of Mary's total trust in God. Bless them with wisdom, that they may promote peace and justice among the peoples of the world. We pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the religious life, especially to the Divine Word missionaries and the Holy Spirit sisters. May our young men and women be open to listen and generously respond to God's invitation to accept a life of religious service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For los pobres, los imprimidos, los que padecen enfermedades, los que son víctimas de los desastres y los que son perseguidos, para que experimenten el amor y el poder salvador de Dios en sus vidas. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por nuestros benefactores y todos los misioneros del mundo, especialmente los misioneros del Verbo Divino y los misioneros del Espíritu Santo, Que el Señor proteja y bendiga su trabajo y que sus vidas sean signos vivos del reino de Dios aquí en la tierra. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our brothers Cara and Derek, who have professed their perpetual vows today, may they find lasting fulfillment in the dedication of their lives to the Society of the Divine Word and the Church. We also pray for their families and friends who have supported and nurtured their religious vocations. May the infinite goodness of our Lord shine upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all the Divine Word missionaries around the world, that we continue to walk in the footsteps of Jesus in order to make his presence felt in our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Almighty God, we believe that you are here with us. We ask you to keep us always in your love, to bless the mission on earth, and bless all of us here, and bless the prayers according to your will. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received with reverence the divine mysteries, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to inflame with the fire of the Holy Spirit these your servants bound to you now by an act of sacred offering, and to admit them forever to the company of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
I'm Mark Weber, the rector of our Divine Word Theologate, and we just wish to thank a number of people before we close our liturgy today. First of all, let's thank Carl and Derek. We thank you for inspiration and blessing. We also want to thank your parents, your families, and nurtured you. Thanks to all of the SVDs and all those friends, all those family members who have supported and guided and encouraged Derek and Carl along the way. We'd like to thank the parish community here of St. Thomas the Apostle and their pastor, Father Trail, for their hospitality in welcoming us to this beautiful sacred space. Thank all the conquerors of the Theologate community who have worked in preparing today's liturgy, and all those who have been involved in it. Especially we want to thank our presider and provincial brother, Huang Lu. Also, we want to thank very much our preacher today, Father Steve Bell. Thank all the musicians, cantors, and all those who helped the community. And we want to thank in advance those who have prepared the reception at the Theologate, which will follow, especially Mrs. Lucy and Joe. You can stand up on you and Lucy's behalf. They're always faithfully feeding us at every celebration. And we also want to thank Ms. Liz Wright, who also has prepared some food for us today. Fully vaccinated guests are most welcome to the reception at the Theologate, just one block up and one block over, basically, 5342 South University Avenue. Please wear your mask, except when you are eating or drinking, which will be most of the time. Thank you.
They have worked closely and guided this choral and them for those years information. So thank you very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.